All right, Boo Boo, you're up, boy. You're up, you boy.
How long does a heavy
10,
crossbow take to
15, 20.
load and shoot?
What's that?
Here.
The heavy crossbow, how long does that take
Takes a full round to
to
load.
Are you fucking kidding me? See, this is what
the
happens
same as the light
right
crossbow?
after that fucking bullshit.
That's a confirmed miss. Or fumble. Fumble-rooski.
Roll
That's
1d 100 fucking 62. Give it to me.
Oh, shit.
Bullshit. There's another error I missed. Yo, I think I got like an upset stomach with this IBS shit. I'm just calling it right now.
All right. I'll give you the choice. Either your bow is gonna break or your arm is gonna break.
Oh, fuck me. Let's do my fucking arm.
No, Bo, what are you doing? Wait, can I heal broken bones?
Yes, you're a healer, right? I would assume so.
Well,
Hoping.
I mean, I was
not
assuming I can, like,
immediately.
well,
do
baby,
touch
after
these
this
bones.
battle, right? Is what I'm thinking. Yeah, we'll see, but whatever. If I don't have a bow, I'm useless. If I break my arm, at least it can heal over time.
You got a sword, though.
Yeah, we didn't say which arm. I'm not gonna use my main hand. But
I would say let the weapon break.
what if it's my left arm and I fucking am a righty? Can we go that way?
Sure.
Why do
You're
you
still
know this
gonna
is a DM?
be down one arm though.
For a
And
short
unable
period of
to shoot
time.
bow.
Well, for some time.
But healers can heal bones, right?
Well, if she heals you, then the bone should set, but it'll still be weak. You know, right? Like in
I don't have
combat, I
any healing
mean.
spells left.
Fard,
Dum-dum?
we got one fight. This guy's pretty much almost dead. All right, fine. The bow breaks, but you better buy me a new one.
I'm not buying you a new one.
This is why I shouldn't have choices like this. I picked the most obviously logical. No, I'm gonna stick with my choice. I break my left arm.
Drew, Lou, do you trust me?
I trust. Well, you're the DM. I don't have a choice.
Break the bow. Always let the weapon break. Trust me.
Really?
Trust
All
me.
right.
I totally thought he was
We're
gonna
in the
shoot me
trust
in the back
tree
of the
with
head.
the nest.
Can we explain this logical sense though later in a
Yes.
distant future? Yeah, find the bow breaks.
Okay.
Why'd you even give me the choice of breaking an arm? Did you think I was just gonna go for the bow anyways?
Yeah, well, yeah.
You just wanted me to look a fool. I see how it
No,
works.
it's all right. It's all right. Astrid,
Like it probably
it's you.
drops a
It's up to
bow.
you, Astrid, to save the day. You
But
stop the
I'm
bad
paralyzed
guys.
and I can't do
You
anything.
save the day.
I don't have a ranged weapon, so I'd have to get all up in his Sahuagin face to attack him. Well, it has reach, my long spear, but I'd still have to get like real close to him. And I don't know if I like the sound of that.
Delay.
Yeah, I'm gonna delay.
Jack! Put your yogurt down. Time to do work.
I don't wanna work!
I'm not hungry! You just ate!
I'm going to
Ma'am!
try and hit him.
Good. This.
hate
Next is me. Oh, Scruffles. You
No
like to
touchy.
play with inflict, huh?
No touchy.
So you want to play with magic?
Well then he shall smite thee.
Like
No
the Star Wars
smiting.
song.
Oh,
Smiting, no
he's
smiting.
smiting.
I only got 4 health, come on.
Hit.
Good night. Great prince.
I die, I'm dead. May I remind you, sir?
Can't
Oops.
him.
1d8
Why are
plus
you
6.
so bad?
Don't say that to him, he's gonna kill
11
you. See
damage.
what happens
Oh
when you
my god, I'm
talk crap,
down.
you're dead.
Well, she's at, like, what, -7?
Yeah.
She's almost fucking dead.
Oh, God.
And she can't come back. She's already
and
died
no
once.
And no DI.
You Euphigenia, no!
He's just returning the favor.
Ooh, look at that health bar. Ugh.
Good. Ugh. Alright, roll to stab Blasio.
Oh, doing the things.
Roll
right.
to wait, Mayor de Blasio.
10.
Close. Alright. We're
get
moving
points
turns.
For close, Soglor. Shut up.
And initiatives!
I'm on delay still, so I'm not gonna roll.
Okay.
Why do you keep saying on delay?
I'm on delay.
This is bullshit.
You're gonna be fine, sweetheart. No, you're gonna be fine. No, I'm gonna be like Charles Schultz. Alright, you bajanumna.
Come on, you can do it!
Oh, no, that wasn't.
Thank you for that follow, derpity derp.
Where's the 10? There it is. 10!
Hey, boo boo!
Oh, now I'm at -8. Son of a bitch.
Oh no!
So. Five.
My quick! Quick! 10,
15. Twenty-five.
Whoop.
Son. Sneaking up behind him. That short sword. Whoops. Sorry. That wasn't supposed to happen. That short action, right?
Short sword.
Which is +2 right now. And I'm gonna fucking... Oh, how much do I get for flanking on top of...
You're not flanking, because Scruffles is down.
Oh, God damn it, Scruffles. And I was here.
Sorry!
Also, you... Even though you moved, like... Here, let me put you back where you were.
Yeah.
You moved, like, here, and then here.
No,
then
no. I didn't do that.
Right. I'm just trying to point out, like, you moved in and out of a threatened square and then backed into a threatened square, so I could have I would have taken an attack of opportunity on that.
Did I move him... Hold on, did I do this instead of this?
Yes.
Oh, I meant to do... Sorry.
Okay, I'm just saying.
Right, yeah, no, I'm aware. I was trying to...
I was just trying to figure out what you were doing. Yeah, I was like, why?
I moved all the way around doing this weird thing, so I didn't get that act, and I guess I dropped the guy in the red square. He's going everywhere today. But yeah, so I'm up behind him, so I get the +2 because I don't have flanking because Scruffles had to go and I don't do shit anyways. I'm fucking just dry today. I don't know what. My mojo left with that surprise attack.
Jack!
Marking
I'm
arrow.
Going to attempt to whip it real good.
Whip it good!
Totally helped me get into a flanking position.
18 is a miss, I'm very sorry.
Oh my god, what is up with this guy and fucking everybody missing?
Alright, initiatives.
I'm still on delay.
Yeah, matching initiatives.
What? Fucking quit moving up on the thing. See, why can't I get like 19? Like attack roll and shit, that'd be great.
Alright. You're up, boo-boo.
Swing and a miss, baby. Here we go.
Is it delayed?
Me? No, I'm gonna fucking...
Oh.
It's fucking... It might as well be fucking forever, because it's not gonna hit shit. Jesus Christ. What the fuck is wrong with my guy?
Alright,
distracted by the farts.
Go ahead and take another attack, because he's going to cast and not defensively. Because he's reckless.
Oh, yes! And it's a crit, because it's a short sword. The 13 doesn't confirm.
Doesn't confirm, but still a hit.
So I do... I can't do 3 times critical, because it's not a fucking... short bow, or two times. So it's not a critical hit, it's a regular hit, right?
It's a regular hit, yeah. Just regular damage.
Fuck. Son of a bitch.
So I think short sword is d6 plus whatever your strength is.
I don't have any strength modifier.
Well, you get the plus one from trip, at least.
I thought it's been 5 rounds.
Well, I'm assuming that you're doing it, because you can do it, like, in and out. I'm assuming you kept it going.
I thought I could only cast
seven.
Seven damage. He's good. Dead.
Fuck yeah, I won the game!
Yay! Demonize me, you fucks!
Okay.
You literally brought him to zero.
Yes.
He had 7 hit points left. You had to roll that max damage. Good job, Lou.
Alright,
that was a tough fight. You guys are gonna get buck XP from that.
A level!
But, I do need somebody... I do need somebody to stabilize Scruffles before she bleeds out.
We're like -8 right now.
So whoever has the highest wisdom or heal check.
Who has...
That'd probably be the
highest wisdom.
Caster.
I am just rolling
motherfuckers is gonna roll a 1 and kill me.
I'm just rolling a straight d20. Anyone else have higher?
I got +1 to it. What's your plus wisdom, Travis? Sorry.
Oop.
Trip.
Travis,
he's been true named!
Okay.
Now face his fury.
The Hadozi, try it, because you get +1.
Really?
You got a better chance than anybody else.
I have... no wisdom bonus.
Gotta fucking start renaming people in Skype before I drop true names everywhere and like somehow give some demon control of your body.
True name magic, it's a bitch.
Yeah, dude. It's like, you true name somebody on the internet, you might as well have just personally doxed them on 4chan.
Wow.
Just kidding, I'm being dramatic. So,
it'll just be d20 plus 1.
Plus 1. 15. You're good to go.
Hey.
Can I collect my arrows? Do I gotta roll the 1d fucking...
How many?
Calling highs. There's like 1, 2, 6, 7 arrows.
Seven arrows... Can you even roll odd? I would think you'd be able to roll d7, even though it's not a real die. Try it.
You can roll pretty much anything and roll 20.
Yeah, try rolling d7.
1d7.
Mm-hmm.
I get 6 of my arrows back. Is that what you're going for?
Yeah. Because, like, sometimes, like, you over a long enough period of time, you'd be able to find them, but some of them might break, but they might get blunted, that kind of shit. They lose fletching, they're not useful anymore for whatever reason.
I can just make more arrows than ever.
Alright, so I'm assuming you guys probably want some experience, right?
Yeah, how about a magical bow on his body that's awesome as fuck and, like, composite?
Alright, let's see.
Tint.
There's 4 of you, and you're all level 2, correct?
Yeah. Yes.
And I got a solo kill.
Trip, did you level Trip?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, because the last thingy...
Who got a solo kill?
Me.
Eric.
I did.
Everyone but me, I think.
No,
I didn't get a solo.
Yeah.
She fucking clotheslined the one that I was about to solo kill. Which was good, by the way, because that bitch probably would have fucking...
And I pew-pewed the green guy and the other one that was near us that you also attacked, so I didn't get any solo kills either.
I swear to God, whenever I play, like, range characters, I get, like, cursed with, like, not being able to hit shit.
So that'll be... Wow, that's a lot of experience. That's good, though. Because I want you guys to level. I'm kind of, like, power leveling you guys. Like, that's why these encounters are so tough. Kind of throwing you to the wolves.
Just please don't kill us.
Kind of like a Russian roulette.
Scruffles.
Uh-huh.
615. And 575 for everybody else.
2150.
575.
How are you still ahead of me in experience, Emma? The fuck?
She got solo kills. She got her red solo kills.
Level 3 is 3,000, right?
Are we resting here?
Yes.
Can I get my spells back?
Yes, you have to rest.
You're unconscious. Because
you're straight up out of spells, so you can rest.
Okay. And I'm going to grab... I'm going to grab Cure Moderate Wounds instead of Enlarge Person. Shut up.
I'll enlarge your person. Whoa.
Wow.
Alright, you ready, Loot Lady? The Loot Lady.
Oh, hold on, sorry. I'm grabbing the spell.
Oh, can I heal back up from zero?
Yeah, you'll heal as you rest.
I have a quick question about Bard.
Well, I'm not going to answer you. No, I'm just going to go.
Because you said I kept casting the thing after 5 rounds. I can only cast that once a day.
Oh. Well, it doesn't matter. I gave it to you. It was the 5th round that combat ended on. Because DM said so. Alright. Two composite longbows.
Cups.
What?
Cups.
Yeah.
Give one to the.
I'm gonna take one of those composite longbows.
Yeah, take one.
Bows.
Write down one or whatever. Look up the stats. Cause it's you use strength now.
I don't have any, so but it's still. I don't have a bow either, so.
Hang on. Awesome. I've got the thingy right up here.
Also, in this room, you're gonna find a Heward's handy haversack.
Yay!
What the fuck is that? That sack
Blue
that holds
bag.
Everything?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's the same thing that Wilborga has.
The composite longbow does 1d8, and the crit is x3.
Alright.
And it's composite, so you get your strength bonus on that, if any.
Right.
And it shoots 110 feet.
That's the range increment.
Death by Donut. We roll for heal because they might horribly fail at stabilizing me and actually murder me.
Yeah.
So it's just for horrible, horrible things to happen, pretty much.
Alright. Two Masterwork Longswords.
Masterwork Longswords.
Two Heavy Steel Shield. Two Chainmail. A trident.
Cool.
And a chain shirt.
And yay, nothing I can
two,
give me some
two potions.
Sick armor. Come on.
Do you use a shield?
No, I got a great sword.
That's right.
I don't think I can use a shield.
Not with a great sword.
Well, not the great
sword. Well, not with a great sword, but I thought that I couldn't use it.
No, you can use a shield.
You have proficiency
you
with all except
swords?
Tower
get
shields, I think.
Armor yeah. Checks.
Okay. Just one.
Because like that would totes like you in a mace. Would totes help you with that AC?
And somebody
yeah,
detect magic.
I will detect magic.
Oh, trap.
No, you gotta save your spells. I didn't use any spells.
Seven level
just
zero.
Detect magic. Calm down.
You get 7 level 0 spells, and the only level 0 spells I can use are Detect Magic, Read Magic.
Yeah, but Trip's useless otherwise. Let him detect magic.
Yeah, I don't get to do anything else.
He never gets to cast spells.
Well, I get Disrupt Undead, which damages undead, but we haven't encountered any yet.
Haha! That's what you get for trying to metagame. You're like, I remember a lot of undead. Didn't think old dog knew. Didn't think I knew about your plan to metagame. Haha! Thwarted! Thwarted you are!
When do I get another feat?
Alright, so you find a magic ring.
Yay!
Sick. Another one?
Magic ring!
I put it on!
Do you already have a magic ring?
I
have,
well,
I have a magical ring written down.
Oh yeah,
that's the one that Ammo has. That
but we don't know that. Well, my character doesn't know that.
It's the same kind of ring.
So I'm gonna delete. Okay, I'm just gonna keep this ring on. Magic ring. So I get plus one to my AC. Poke.
Yep, it's a deflection bonus.
This mod.
I don't
know
about
this one. Yeah, 15 AC.
Is there not a spot for deflection? I think there is.
Oh, sorry. Dex size natural deflection.
Yep, put it in deflection.
Okay.
Why don't you? Alright, I just have to run to the bathroom real quick, and then I'll be right back. We don't have to take, like, a break. It'll take me, like, less than a minute. So, I'll be right back.
Okay.
You guys decide amongst yourselves, and also casters, if you want to change out spells, now would be the time, because you're resting.
Right.
So,
well,
I will be right back.
I have to, like, learn the spell, and then it's permanent. Like, I don't get to pick whatever spells I feel like. I have to learn. I can learn 5 level 0 spells and 2 first level spells. I don't get to swap them out when I feel like.
Damn it. Stupid. Why are... Rah.
The cool part about Sorcerer, though, is I only know 2 first level spells, Magic Missiles and Shield, but I could cast Shield 5 times, or Magic Missiles 5 times, or any combination of the two.
What's the shield thing do?
It gives me bonus to my AC. Which, if I'm not in range of being attacked, is not, like, I'd rather use magic.
Take, like, one of those, because that'll last, like, the whole round, that shield thing, won't it?
Let me check how long it lasts. 1 second. Ah! Drop!
Okay. By the way, I totally forgot that there's a new season of Vikings that started tonight, so...
Oh, shit, really?
Super
excited. I gotta catch up on season 2.
Oh, wait,
fucking
I can't
show
get
Cure
Moderate
awesome.
Wounds yet, can I?
No, it's a 3rd level spell.
No, it's a 2nd level spell. In the healing domain, but I don't get 2nd level spells until I get 1 level
until
2nd
level.
Until 3rd level. Okay. I guess I'll just keep my shitty Cure Light wounds then.
They're not shitty. They done kept you alive. Alright, so anything else you want to search before you rest?
I can't search nothing. I am out.
Oh, and on the table, a lot of it's just like war planning stuff like that, but you find a map of the known world. Which I will show to you now.
Yay! Same one that I have,
Yeah, more or less, but there's one I put into Roll20 so that people at home can see.
Ooh. Oh. I thought we weren't on the map anymore. What?
No, you just don't know where you are.
What about that red mark there? Is that where we are?
Yes, but you don't know that unless I get
Sailor
a knowledge cat? Geography.
Oh,
I have that shit, yo. Plus 5. 13.
It's good enough. You can estimate that that's your current position.
Yo, look, David marked on the map for us.
If you look on the map where it says the Sword Coast, there's like those black dots like moving in a line.
Mm-hmm.
Like that was your charted course for where you were when you shipwrecked, and then the red signifies like where you went after that. Like right around here is where you shipwrecked, and then you ended up somewhere around here or here.
Okay, so we were coming this way, right?
Going to swing around to over here.
But we just kept going that way. Someone forgot to start turning, and then we crashed.
Or they attacked us and shipwrecked us.
I'm pretty sure someone just forgot to turn.
I'm
kidding.
Pretty
just kidding.
Sure. Why would they have a map?
He's like, I'm 100% sure.
I'm sitting here like, dude, trust me. They totally didn't know we were coming. This is just coinkydink. And someone fucking fell asleep at the wheel and just kept cruising straight right into them rocks. There's no way they're that bad of guys. Come on.
All right, so let me put you guys back on the
regular
Dango Wago.
This is some Google Maps fancy stuff right there.
Oh, we get fancy.
Yo, don't judge me, Scruffles.
It's no judgment here.
She's got her judging face on.
Why do you judge him?
Yeah,
judging!
Oops. Over there. I can feel the judgment eyes. See? And the judgment sigh.
I heard that. I heard that shit.
What are these things at the end? Are they like holes?
These are like chairs.
Poopy holes?
Chairs. You could poop on them if you want, but there's no hole for the poop to go through, so you're going to end up with poopy butt, and then you're going to catch
disease.
It's
not my fault. It's fucking Thoglor.
Says the one with IBS.
He had one thing where, like...
He did, like, two.
No, there wasn't even a poop scene.
Two big-ass chests there, and she wants to know about the fucking chairs.
Wait, that stuff we got isn't from the chest? We haven't opened those yet?
You haven't opened the chests.
Why the fuck haven't we opened up the chests yet,
yo? Haven't searched them for traps yet. God.
I'll fucking check them bitches for traps right now.
All right, you do that. Right, I'm not going to stand near it, though. I take it back.
Fucking search is... three. That's for one chest. That's for another. I think they're both trapless or maybe trap-free. What are they, Thug?
You don't see any traps.
Yeah, they look there. Those things are 100% trap-free. You can go ahead
but
and
they are locked.
But they are, yes, they are locked. Indeed.
Can
and
we search
I don't...
the room for keys?
Yeah, what's there wasn't keys on any of the bodies.
Give
underneath
me a search
the cushions
check.
Of the chair, maybe it's slipped underneath there, you know,
on
like
the chain.
What, who has the highest search? Like, what's your ranks? And...
I get +3.
Mine's just a straight.
I get +3 as well.
Can't we all, like, work together? It's just... Never mind, I don't know. Shut up.
I'll let you
stop
take 20, and you find the keys for it in the basin.
That's a weird
it would
place.
Put
you
him in the
takes.
Water, that cheeky fool.
It's where the swag in the water.
Alright, hold on, let me change the music. No longer combat.
Really appropriate for searching chests.
I'm just gonna put on the post-fight music. So you're opening the chests?
Yep.
You find 4 potions.
Yeah.
A set of masterwork full plate.
What do I have to do to be able to, like, wear plate and not get it super rusty by seawater? Take your time.
I'm sure there's something we could figure out.
Okay. Should I put it on now? Probably, yes. Is it better than my chitin armor? D&D. 3.5. Was it full plate armor?
Let's see. You're also going to find 500 gold.
Oh. 500 gold. Okay.
And since somebody detected magic, a magical whip.
I give the magical whip to Jack.
Yeah. Deco Jack.
Jack, write down magical whip.
I haven't gotten anything.
You can just write down +1.
Hey, you
whip.
Have a bonus to AC.
Is it the same as the other whip, but just +1?
Yep. You're gonna get +1 to attack and +1 to damage.
Damn.
Yay!
Yay. I think Ammo should get the trident.
Oh, yeah.
I think I can use the trident.
She's not proficient with it.
Oh,
it's not a simple weapon.
Yeah, I thought it was like a staff, but with a pointy end.
No, it's daggers. It's like a giant fork.
Daggers, mace, sickle, club, mace, heavy, morning star, short spear, long spear, quarterstaff, spear.
I believe trident is either a martial or exotic weapon.
Trident is a one-handed martial weapon. So says... the player's handbook thing. I have it open. I'm looking at it right now.
Is that it for Luke?
If we find another sling,
yep.
I can use that.
Let's check out.
What kind of idiot you gotta be to not be able to use a trident? You stick him with the pointy.
That uses magic.
Okay, Ned Stark.
You didn't say that.
Or no, it was that right. Rob or John? That told Arya that.
John.
With what?
It was John, because he gave her the sword.
Yeah, I thought Stick oh, I thought he asked her.
First lesson.
Like, you
stick him with the pointy end.
Yeah, something like that. Is it either John or Arya? Because I thought she was like, you stick him with the pointy end.
She said that to Ned later on.
Oh, right.
Because Ned was like, you don't know the first thing about swords. She was like, yeah, I do. Stick him with the pointy end. Ha ha! Up your ass, old man. Well, except for that last part. That was entirely accurate.
Should I go with the full plate armor? I should get a ranged weapon, because I have dex plus 2.
I would get a minus 6 on my check penalty, though. From a minus 3 to a minus 6. But I would get 8 bonus rather than 4. No? No helpies? Cool.
One more time.
Full plate mail armor over the chitin armor that I have, or chitin, whatever.
Well, chitin. How do the bonuses differ?
Armor bonus plus 8, armor check penalty minus 6 for the full plate. For the chitin, it's armor bonus plus 4, check penalty minus 3.
I would go with the full plate, because you can wear it.
Alright, cool beans.
Better AC. And because it's masterwork, the check penalty is going to be minus 5 instead of minus 6.
Oh, still. Ouch. 8. Masterwork. Full. Oh. Eight. Okie dokie. Oh, my AC is 19 now.
Oh, shit.
Yay.
You guys have a tank.
Sick.
Well, I have 19. Can they both?
Does she have to use a greatsword?
Except not my climb.
Well, it's her deity's
six,
favorite
yeah,
weapon.
Yeah.
Oh, because I was going to say, can't she take one of those, like, long swords and use the shield?
She could.
No, I love Torm, and Torm is important, and he loves me, too. He specifically wanted me to have a greatsword, okay? Don't question Torm. Okay.
Wow.
Wow, yo.
Plan the class.
Don't question him.
Plan the class.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
Question, my god.
Yeah, Death by Donuts got, like, all the min-max OP shit.
Look at the big brains on this fucker.
Yeah, that's like advanced stuff. Like, these guys are all very new to the game, so eventually they'll be making OP characters, but we're keeping it simple for now. But I am helping them, like, as far as, like, where they want to put their ability scores for different classes and different shit like that.
I got yelled at for not having knowledge religion.
Yeah, what are you doing? You're a cleric.
No, I don't know!
Exactly. See what happens when I leave these fools to their own devices? Also, are you keeping the mirror?
Yes.
Okay.
Why would I not?
The hand mirror that you fucking...
She likes to primp and preen in.
Yeah, I gotta, like, look at it.
Throughout, like, the whole adventure now, she's always gonna be, like, walking, looking at it.
Making sure like, my habit is all, like... properly on and shit.
And we're probably gonna go for like another hour or so. Give or take. So, you guys can rest. Did you change spells if you would like to?
I think I changed what I want. Cure Light Wounds. That's all I really need to change.
Okay. So I assume you guys will be sallying forth?
See.
Forth Sally.
Yay.
Alright. All the way at the bottom.
What the fuck? Oh. There's like a cliffside fucking...
Yeah, you're, like, on the side of the mountain on a ledge, and you're, like, so high up that you're basically, like, just above the cloud cover.
We've been going up the whole time, haven't we?
You've been going up, like, pretty much the whole time since you went in.
Jesus fucking Christ.
We're in the other thing we did, we kept going down.
This is like a pretty steep incline, too. Like, it's like, probably like an incline like that. So I'm gonna need, climb checks for everybody to move along.
Fuck. You're kidding me? It's minus 6 now.
That's my climb. 26. Mine takes a straight throw.
You're good.
I can just go to the top.
Yeah.
Bye, suckers.
8.
Oh.
Yep. 8 and 2, you ain't going nowhere.
This balance? Is gonna be great. I'm just gonna sit here and watch.
No, you don't have to balance, because you're on, like, an incline. You just can't, you can't get your footing.
We're trying
you're not making
to,
any
like,
progress.
Upward, but not going anywhere.
So do we have to keep doing this over and over again until we succeed?
For each 5 feet we
Jack
go.
Is good. Girls
what
suck
do?
At climbing, confirmed.
Wow. Oh. Fight me.
I will outclimb you any day, Scruffles.
I doubt that. I've been climbing lately.
I have tiger blood and Adonis DNA. You can't even compete. You can't even compete.
Sorry, I wasn't aware of real world experience.
If we're going to have a climb off, we're going to need to hire a paramedic to be on staff for when I inevitably break your heart by outclimbing you.
I'm good paramedic, very cheap.
Give me $5, and then he just leaves. And she'll be fine.
So what are we doing?
Waiting for you guys to get up here.
People at the top can throw a rope down.
I do that.
Do we have rope? When did we get
yes,
rope?
We
lost
tons,
everything in the shipwreck. Oh yeah, that's right. We
rope.
Got.
You found rope.
But and lots of
can
rope.
We just watch him again? Try again?
Yeah, we should just watch him try again.
Yeah, it's up. It's up to y'all.
How are they ever gonna learn if you don't?
Exactly.
It's like
I ain't making it up in my full ass plate armor.
It's kind of funny watching you struggle though. I'm not gonna lie. I just picture like just face slamming, falling like right into the rocks and shit. Her like helmet's getting stuck. She's like got a rock wedged in there.
Are you guys gonna throw down a rope? Or
yeah, I'd
what?
Throw down a rope. You're a lost cause. You're gonna need all the help you gain.
Dude, I'm your tank. I'm in full plate armor.
Technically, you're a
tank
healer.
Tank that's not using a shield.
I am your tank and healer.
Maybe if you had a shield, you'd have a counterbalance to help you climb up. You know, you could use
I'm
it
so
as
sick
just.
Of you but children you got, arguing with me.
Not arguing with you. We're just taunting you from a higher vantage point.
We have the high ground.
Yeah. That's what it was there for.
Alright, hold on a second. People. Listen, Death by Donut. You can DM and run a game any way you choose. If you don't like the way I DM, that's too bad. Sorry, don't know what to tell you, man. Don't backseat DM me, because that shit's going to piss me off. But
yeah,
please, continue.
So now do we roll a climb with the rope assisting us?
Give it another whirl. I'm giving you a bonus for the rope.
I rolled a 15.
You're good,
on
with
my
a 5.
Up.
We're good, okay.
You're good with a 5. Yeah.
Did I make it up with my 15 that I rolled as my second roll when
yes.
I failed the first time?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
It's nothing too crazy. It's just like...
Very steep.
Right, and like, there's... You're like just coming up out of the cloud cover, so it's kind of like slick rocks too, you know what I mean? Like, it's almost like, dew, something like that.
Okay.
So, go ahead and move your characters.
Boop. Boop. She's gotta fix her hair first.
Just imagine her in, like, full plate, gets a top, slips on, like, moss, lead, and all the plates.
Fucking hair. Sometimes. Even when it's short.
Hold on, let me make sure I did that right. And we shall move you to the next map.
We Where are we? Oh no, there's a dude.
Alright, so you like.
He sees us immediately.
Hold on, let me just move this so people can in chat can see. Zoom out a little bit. There we go. Alright, so you you get to like the top, and then like it's almost like a corner on the side of the mountain. Like the mountain's almost like on that corner, it's almost like the edge of a knife. You know what I mean? And then it continues down the other side, but it's still like going up slightly. Ahead of you, you see a very disheveled looking man just like sitting on a cart and pile of boulders behind him on top of what kind of looks like a drawbridge. As soon as you round the corner, the guy looks at you and he just doesn't do anything. He just sits there.
Okay. I'm like, I say to them, wait one second. Let me handle this. I'm going to go be a diplomat.
Oh.
Wait. Can I cast
my cabbages?
Fleeting Flame on him? +2 to bluff, diplomacy, intimidate.
I don't know. Can you?
I can't.
Well, that some of those kind of spells are personal only, so that's why you gotta look
like
up the spells.
Shield is personal only.
Oh, that's because 2.5. What? No, fleeting flame isn't coming up. It only comes up as fireball.
Anon, that was me. My cabbage.
Is it from a dragon magazine? Is that why?
Oh, that's why. Never mind. I can't.
Like I said, like I'm not opposed to allowing spells from Dragon Magazine, but you gotta find the issue and you gotta find the information on it.
What the heck is Dragon Magazine?
Thought that it said Player's Handbook.
It's like a magazine about D&D and other like tabletop games. Yeah. Well, there's been some really cool stuff in Dragon Magazine over the years. Or like a big thing they'll do is they'll take books that have been written about various campaign settings, and then they'll actually go and... Alright, hold on a second.
Ooh.
Oh, I did it first. Did you want...
Yeah. Don't advertise your shit in my stream. So, yeah, if anybody wants to go watch an asshole DM, I guess. But anyway, like Dragon Magazine, they'll take books like and characters from those books, and then they'll like do out the whole character creation of them, like what their various abilities would be, the different spells they would have prepared, magical items, all that kind of shit. So it's like if you're really into the books and you want to kind of push those into the game a little bit, which I've done in the past and worked out really fucking well. Well,
I didn't see that. It just seems like every time I hear stuff like, can't use it from there, it's like, what is this magazine just all about? Like, yo, how to be super OP and break and bend shit.
It can be to a degree, but not necessarily. Because I'm pretty sure it's all done through Wizard.
So like, I can't find the
Wizards
soothing
of the Ghost
voice spell you had me write down. But it uses one bardic music and... Diplomacy check equals will DC as spell calm emotion.
Oh, that's a variant thing for, that's because you're half drow. It has something to do with that. It's something we did at character creation. It's like half elf variant. So it's not a spell, it's a bardic music ability. And that's not gonna help you because he already looks calm. Like, you're basically using your bardic music to cast calm emotions. If you want to make a note of that.
Okay, well, I have a 7 diplomacy.
Right on, TCU Frogs.
Nice.
Welcome to the stream. We play in the 3.5 rule set, so... Like, the way I figured is, like, I know 3.5 the best, and if you know 3.5, you can jump right into 4 and 5. Pretty easily. Like, not much changes. If anything, it gets easier, so.
Can I walk up to him and be like, hey friend, how's it going? Would that be a diplomacy check?
Are you gonna walk up to him? Move that character, bruh.
Well,
don't walk too far.
Well, like there.
Okay. He's gonna look at you and give like kinda like a half hearted like an okay, like alright wave. But he doesn't say anything.
Okay. I'm gonna ask him if it's okay if we can just pass along through.
Thank you for that follow, delicious pack. What are you rolling, diplomacy?
Delicious pack.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, there's a lot of good Star Wars, like, D20 based stuff. One of them is, like, really good, but the source books are super fucking expensive. Like, the core book, I think, is, like, 100 plus bucks, if you can even find it.
What?
Is it just because it's so rare?
Yeah, it's, like, out of print now. I forget the exact name of the setting, but...
Someone needs to put that...
Something Empire. Yeah. It had something to do with the Empire.
I rolled a 24.
On your diplomacy?
Yeah.
Okay, like, he seems friendly enough. He looks like a slave. He's wearing a collar.
Okay. I motion to them to come up.
Okay.
Thank you for the follow, Zildren.
To him.
I think I said that right. If I didn't, I'm sorry.
I'd like to ask him, what's he doing here?
Why he's like behind him?
He's gonna like point at his mouth and like make like a...
Oh, he's a mute.
He's mute.
Can I ask him if he knows Drosai? Oh.
Please hold. Scruffles, give me a heal check.
Oh.
They kind of throw.
It's like in pain.
Thank you for the follow, DCU okay. Frogs.
I'm
guessing they cut his tongue out.
Yep, he opens his mouth and shows you a stump where a tongue should be.
Cut out your tongue, that's terrible.
Can I ask
I, like,
him if he knows Drow sign language?
Can you, like, sign to him?
He's human.
And see if he responds.
Oh.
Can I take the collar off of him?
Anyone have a pen and...
Do I know regular sign? Like, does it go both ways? Or is it, like, two completely different things?
Two completely different things. Oh. He's gonna motion to you like this.
Does anyone have a
pen and paper?
Answer me, can I take his stupid collar off?
Sure.
Cool. I've got... linen, I've got, like, a dagger, and I've got a flask of oil. Lint and tinder.
You could sort of write with the oil on the linen. Like, finger paint.
Yeah, that would work.
I guess I'll just lay out that stuff and be like, there you go.
He's gonna write, like, sort of, like, truncated. Because, like, obviously it's, like, an awkward way to write, so he's just gonna give you, like... like sentence fragments, almost. He's gonna write slave, was bard, can't sing.
Oh, poor baby. That's so tragic.
And like after you take his collar off, you see that like his neck is like all bruised up. Like they fucked up his voice box too. So he can't even like, you know. Like,
oh, that's sad. Can I give him a hug?
Like, even without a tongue, like, your voice box would still be able to produce noise. Like, his can't. Like, he's been, like, kicked in the neck and shit.
That's fucked up.
Like, he was a singing bard, and they just took what made him away from him.
He's gonna be a performer.
I hug him. Be like, you poor thing.
Listen check.
Oh, shit.
Everybody, or?
Everybody.
Oh, boy. What do I get?
Can I tell him? I guess we can't until we do the listen check. Never mind. Well, we're all terrible.
Who the fuck is
that? 10 is good enough. Like, as long as you can get over 10. Oh, boo boo.
Like, I hear clear, all the things.
Clear as day, you hear, like, coming from this direction, there's, like, a opening there.
What direction? Oh, there, okay, yeah.
And, you hear, like, a hobgoblin voice go, "Where the hell is that cart? I'll have your guts for garters, blah, 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 etc. threatens, blah, blah, blah." And,
I pull out the bow.
Wait, no, hold on. Don't do anything, though.
The bard is going to be, like, motion you to hide.
No, I want to give him, like, a dagger and be like, "Go down to the beach, find Maurice."
No.
Run, we've cleared out the area that
basically
way.
What he's telling you to do is hide and then ambush this hobgoblin.
Yeah, we should hide.
It's like his, that's what he's trying to get across to you.
Like, alright, I'll still give him a dagger, though. We're like, wait, what else do we have? We have a longsword, do you think he can use a longsword?
He's not gonna take a weapon.
He's a bard.
Why not?
Because he's not going to take a goddamn weapon. All
right, well, I make sure that he's like... Wait, is he trying to...
Because he's not suicidal, that's why.
Is he trying to stay in the open and like...
He's going
to
stay exactly where he is.
Oh.
Where I am is
like... I'm just trying to help him. God, he's so stubborn.
He's trying to help you.
Okay. Is that like a wall? Like, am I around a corner?
Astrid, can you move your...
Or would right there be around the corner?
Oh, yeah.
You're still visible there, Trip.
Here we go.
Oh.
You have to like get behind where everybody
get
else
behind
is.
Me.
Yeah, or
and I
yeah, don't
I hide.
Trip, you go in front.
So if you guys want to roll hide checks now, while I pull out the miniature.
Oh my god, I've got a minus 5. I'm the worst at hiding.
-2.
Anything negative on a skill is just an automatic 1.
You just hold up a twig and you're like, "Guys, I'm hidden. Look."
Oh shit, I did take off his collar. Fuck. Oops. Oh well, we're gonna kill the fucking hobgoblin.
Why did you take off your collar?
Yeah, and I ready a whip attack for when he comes around the... Oh, I thought he was coming.
Well, he comes out like here. And then he starts screaming at the bard and immediately just starts laying into him, like, beating the shit out of him.
I attack him.
Yeah, can we all... Do we all get, like, a free attack, pretty much? Since, like, I want to run up to him, who's going to want to shoot him?
Whoever can attack from range can attack, and then combat begins.
Go, boo, boo.
Okay, I'm gonna... Pew, pew, pew!
Oh, I was gonna be like, here's your collar
everybody
and whip him around the throat.
Can I get him from here? Oh,
yeah.
I can get him. Okay, I don't even have to move.
Alright, so one at a time. We'll do Lou first. Go ahead and attack.
Shoot.
That's a hit.
And I move that...
You move 10.
Yep. So that's 2d6 worth of damage.
Yep.
Oh, wait, that's 2d8. 1d8 of damage and 1d6 of damage. Because I have the composite.
Oh, right.
D8. So what, roll 1d8 plus 1d6? Is that how you do it?
Good question. Try
it.
Yeah,
you can do that.
Let's see what happens.
12. That works.
Yeah.
12 damage heard.
Eight.
Oh, my.
Okay.
And Rachel? I'm sorry. Ammo?
Wow.
I pulled a Lou.
True name.
No! Okay.
She like melts and
pew pew.
Like,
full damage.
Nice.
Ooh.
He's dead.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah, he's dead.
Did we actually kill him?
Damn.
Surprise! You dead, bitch.
Alright.
Loots.
That was pretty cool.
He's gonna like cheer at you guys. Like cheer emote.
Yay.
Slash cheer.
Did that dude have any loot on him?
He had a whip, a short sword, and hide armor.
Oh, hi.
Now can I tell him to go down to the beach and
can we give him
Maurice?
The whip to go down to the beach and meet Maurice?
Are you gonna give him like general directions on where
yeah,
he
like,
should
just
go.
Follow the path that we went on past the tapestry. Down.
Don't touch the flowers.
I lift his shirt
up.
Don't
touch the flowers.
I dip my finger in mud and I paint him a map on his stomach so he knows where to go.
Because he can see that.
Wait, we have to
give me a dex check.
Wait, do we get a 15?
No, wait, hold on. We have to make sure that when finds him, Maurice doesn't freak out and beat the shit out of him.
I sign the name, like, package to Maurice from Bobo with my finger in the mud. This is really good mud for fucking doing tummy paint, let me tell you.
Caesar, kill ape! He's all Koba. Alright, so he's very happy with you. You freed him, you know what I mean?
Did he
like,
take the whip, or no?
Yeah, he took the whip.
Can I give him the hide armor as well?
Hey, I could use hide armor, I think.
Oh.
He's gonna, write using the oil and the linen, and he's gonna write, many enemies ahead, be careful. And he points, into the mountain.
Okay. I say, thank you, dearie. You just be safe now. Get to Maurice, okay?
He nods.
And I tell him, many songs will be made in his name.
Aww.
He hugs you. He gives you a big bro hug. Because now he kind of gets the idea that you're a bard, too. So you know what he's going through.
Yeah.
This poor guy. Oh. This poor guy!
Cheap little baby!
Right in the fields.
But there's nothing across the drawbridge or anything?
No, it looks like they just kind of load rocks onto this and then let the drawbridge fall, and then the rocks all just tumble into the ocean.
Shit, we didn't ask his name.
Whatever lies beneath.
We didn't
ask
his name.
Oh, we don't even know his name.
His name. Pretend we asked that.
How many songs will be named your name?
Here we go.
He's called Mute Black Boy.
I'll let you ask him before he goes. He tells you his name is Jonathan.
Wait. Jonathan?
Jonathan?
Mm-hmm.
No.
Jonathan Cash.
Just come on. Change.
With a K.
Jonathan Change. Jonathan Change with a K. That would make any sense.
Change.
Oh, I get it. Cash. Change. Terrible.
Alright. So he's going to thank you and be on about his merry way.
Man, we destroyed that goblin.
Well, it was just a fucking lackey, you know what I mean? He's a slave driver.
What the? Better than my cord armor.
Hide armor, I think, is the same. Let me check. Alright, armor. What does cord give you?
2 what armor is... bonus.
Yeah, so if you switch to hide, it gives you +3 to your armor bonus. The max dex bonus is 4, so 18. If you're gonna put it on the roll 20 sheet. Armor check penalty is -3. And it's medium armor, so then you would get the arcane spell failure chance, I believe.
Oh.
I don't know if it's light or medium armor that bards can wear.
It was light.
I will check.
Pretty sure it was light.
Still. One second. Bard while wearing medium or heavy armor or using shield incurs a chance of arcane spell failure. So, yeah, you have to wear light.
Didn't you get a chain shirt, though?
And put it on.
Yeah, we got 2 chainmail.
Yeah, which is chain shirt. So use that. Because that's considered light armor.
Oh.
So the stats for that are 4 to your armor bonus. Max dex is 18. The armor check penalty is -2. Yay, more AC for Trip. Hooray for AC.
And I'm still sitting at 12.
Cheer for armor, shout for class. Cheer and shout for armor class. Alright, so it's open session. And like, while you're outside, like, there's like a powerful storm brewing. Like, you can just like feel it in the air, like the clouds beneath you are darkening because you're that high up. And like, even if you look above you, there's like more clouds like in the upper atmosphere that are just swirling around this mountain.
Like a fucking, like impending doom scenario? Is that the word? Impending, right?
Yeah, like, remember in Ghostbusters? It's like that.
Yeah, that's what I thought. I don't like
dogs
this.
And cats living together, mass hysteria.
Wait, what am I taking out of my inventory, by the way? One chain shirt?
Yes.
Okay. I is ready. I is going in the hole.
So I'm thinking, like, I should stealthily take point and kind of scout ahead. And then I will, like, hooty-hoo if I see danger.
Hooty-hoo!
Hoo-hoo!
Oops.
The most, like, it'll sound exactly like the rock owls. That are native to this island.
Uh-oh.
What the fuck?
What? Rock owls.
Abomination. No, look at the screen.
Whoa.
Nobody do anything. I'll fix it.
It's our evil doppelganger twins again. They keep showing up.
Really take this message back to Queen Doppelopolis.
Or they're us from the future telling us how not to die.
That'd be hilarious.
That would be pretty great.
Alright, so map starts at the top.
Yo, oh, it's dark in here.
It is. A couple lanterns light the way, but it's like a rough-hewn mineshaft kind of deal.
So are you telling us to wait here?
Yeah. Just wait here a bit, like, just kind of, like, let me go a lot ahead of you to where, like, and just follow me so I'm, like, barely within sight at all times. And try to be as quiet as possible. Does that make sense?
Should I go with him since I have the dark vision?
I will, like, motion up for you because you're kind of squishy and you got chain, which is kind of loud.
Like, you can tell that the path ahead is lit, like, intermittently by lanterns.
Okay.
Do you want me to move, like, a roll silently for, like, every whatever, or how do you want to do this?
I'll tell you when to roll.
Okay, the move silently when you want it?
Right, and just, like, don't move too far at a time, kind of
thing. How many squares would you like me to
just
move?
Just do, like, your normal movement, which is, like, 30 at a time, and then I'll tell you if you need to do a move silently after that point. Like, I'll give you fair warning, like, ahead of time.
Okay. So in here, I think. Yeah, okay. And then I'm gonna peek around this corner.
Alright. And from here on out, do move silently checks for each movement that you do.
For each, like, oh, every 30 squares?
Well, 30 feet. So
right, yeah,
squares,
30
yeah.
squares, sorry, yeah. That's what I meant.
30 squares?
Every 30
that's some
squares,
crazy
bro.
Fucking movement, man.
Fuck,
fucking
yeah,
Usain
awesome.
Bolt.
You thought you could break D&D. Let me show you how I know, motherfucker.
Let me show you how I does it.
Alright, so, yeah, I turkey peek down here, and it just, is it, like, curling around here? I wish you could see. Okay, yeah, I see what's going on. Okay. So then I hug this wall right here. Oh,
okay.
Shit, hold on. Let me roll my move silently.
Move silently.
So then I turkey peek around here. Are you guys moving with me?
You said to, okay. Fine.
I said you gotta keep me barely in sight, and I just all went around the all corner. All
right, you're still in sight. You're going around the
I'm like looking back and I don't see nobody. Is that a, what does that look like to me?
Looks like another slave.
Another slave?
Mm-hmm.
Is she, like, not paying attention to me right now?
She hasn't seen you yet.
I pick up, like, a little rock. There's got to be, like, a million little rocks, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I kind of, like, throw it in her direction to kind of, like, grab her attention while at the same time, like, shh, and motioning her here, like, in a friendly manner.
As soon as the rock hits, you hear a bunch of other, like, gruff male voices speaking a language you don't understand. But they seem, like, alarmed.
At the little rock that I threw?
Well,
I
didn't, like, chuck like suspicious, or, you know what I mean? Or like, they're like,
I got, like, what? I'm talking about, like,
P-Rock
pebble size, like, little rock to, like, try to actually hit her to get
okay.
her attention.
So, like a pebble. All right.
Yeah.
I like thought you meant you were, like, throwing, like, a rock.
No. I'm, like, just trying, like, the smallest one I can find that, like, if it, like, hit her gently because the distance would grab her attention.
Move silently to move up to the group.
Okay.
What's my move silently? Plus two.
Lou, give me a spot check. But yeah, you, like, got her attention.
Am I quiet enough? I'm not wearing any armor.
Variel, there goes Boo Boo throwing bricks at old slave ladies again. Thank you for that follow, Arrow Tidua.
Look up. Pay attention to me.
Listen to me! Pay attention to me! Oh, that's hilarious. Throwing bricks at old slave ladies. Oh, that's so brutal.
Is 10 enough for ammo to get up here?
Yeah. And 23 was
plus
your
I'm
spot.
I'm not wearing armor.
Oh, 16,
so.
Still good enough. You see, like, she locks eyes with you, and then she kind of, like, gestures, like, down the hall and, like, go, like, makes a no shake. You know what I mean? Like, shakes her head no. Like, warning you.
I make, like, a time watch piece motion and didn't do thrusting motions at her.
What?
In response.
Do I see him doing
what
this?
What are you trying to convey with that?
Do I see him doing this?
I just want to see what she does. I'm, like, living
like
in the moment.
Are
right
you
now.
Asking
like,
her if she's got time to fuck? If that's
time to fuck? Like, time to fuck people up?
DTF?
Right?
Oh my god.
Anyways.
She's going to shake her head no.
So I'm going to sneak up to move here to hide behind this cart
well,
and get further.
I would move like 5 feet at a time and then I'll gradually reveal more.
Okay, so yeah, it's just really hard to tell because like obviously I could see how it curves and then but like the way the so I gotta roll the silent check each five. Okay, I tell you guys to like hold off, like don't move.
Sorry.
He's like nah.
Wait, I'm gonna go in front of the bard though.
All right,
move silently.
Me?
Yeah, you.
Oh man. Mm. It's going to ruin everything.
This is why I told you guys to stay way the fuck away from
I'm sorry! Oh, where the fuck is my move silently? How do I alphabet? It's minus five.
If she's, like, loud as fuck, can I have, like, a reflex save to just be like, fuck, here they come?
Got a 10.
Okay.
Not that bad. Yeah.
I hope it's not that bad.
Hope.
So, what is this right here?
Looks like a dwarf, but, like, stockier, and, like, with, like, rock-skinned color, like, dark gray skin.
Does he look like he'd be evil ever?
He does not look friendly.
He looks like a pretty intimidating kind of guy that just should, like, develop an arrow, like, right here in his face somehow.
Yeah, maybe.
Like, I just stand to full height and shoost at him. While yelling out my war cry to fucking intimidate and demoralize this man.
Well, intimidate's a skill.
Well, I mean, I don't think it actually do that, but that's what I think it does in my head when I yell out the war cry.
So are you gonna attack?
Yeah, surprise attack this motherfucker. Like, ah! So everyone knows to move forward and
give
progress.
Me a spot check.
Spot check, fuck.
So can we move on the...
Just wait. I gotta do a spot check. Quick, getting ahead of yourself, Scruffles.
I scruffle stepping all over Lou.
I don't know, man. I'm trying to do spot checks here. Because
I am the priestess of Torm.
Okay? I am the priestess.
Wow. I was beginning to like you. Now you're getting all self-righteous on me.
I got hit in the head. I have to do it. It's not my fault.
Yo, and I'm a little bit gassy, but I fucking hold it sometimes. There's my spot check.
You notice she makes like a no gesture to you when she sees you pull out the bow. And she gestures to her right and is like, basically she's trying to tell you that they'll fucking kill you. Like, they are strong.
Can we pull back and like set up a trap?
But
come on, I like setting up
traps. You don't even know this stuff yet. You're back there, just hold.
Fine.
Revealing. Revealing. She like motions to a small cramped passage to the left. Well, it'd be your right. Her left, your right, yeah.
So this thing right here?
Yep.
Shit.
But I wanna save her. No, we all have right. to save her. Nope. I'm not gonna be able to go down that.
You don't even know she's there right now.
I'm telling you what's gonna happen in the future. I'm gonna see her.
Well, that's fine. Like, in the future, when you're fucking rushing headlong into death, I'm gonna be in a narrow hidden passageway, safe as fuck.
God damn it.
So, yeah, I move to this hidden passage.
Move silently and hide.
29 and 18.
All right, you're good. Let me reveal some more.
Damn those bonuses.
Yeah, dude, I fucking took care of myself. I am a scout through and through.
Okay, problem number two. I'm not going to be able to sneak past.
That's why I told you to stay there.
I know, but like...
Try your move silently.
No, don't try your move silently. Don't even move until
I don't want to go anywhere until he comes back.
The thing for me to call you is the hootie-hoo, right?
Hootie-hoo!
Or fucking, like... You hear me go, and armor starts clashing and shit. Alright, so...
Is, like, sneaking up behind someone and slitting their throat, like, a thing, like, to get rid of them? Shit.
To be in first edition, like, assassins. Like, in first edition, it's very weird, because, like, assassins and thieves and doing things like that was all based on, like, percentiles. So, like, say for example, in first edition, if you were an assassin and you snuck up behind somebody or you were invisible behind somebody, you would get an assassination attempt, which would be a percentile check. And depending on your level, it would increase as you got higher levels. But I think when it started out, it was like 25% chance for you to assassinate. Like, basically, like, slit somebody's throat.
Why'd they take that out of the game? It was just too OP.
Well, it's almost like an completely different place now, like, as far as the structure of the game. Because, like, in first edition, the armor class is called Thaco. Or Thak Zero, depending on who you're talking to. I've always called it Thaco, but it's Thak Zero. And so, like, having negative armor class was good as opposed to having a higher armor class. So it was very confusing. It was tough for new people to get into it because of that. So I think that's why they changed it in, like, 3rd and 3.5. But, I need to take a quick break. I'll be right back. I'll give you guys a moment to figure out what it is you want to do. But generally what she's trying to convey is, like, if you fight these guys, you're going to lose.
Right, which is why I'm not trying to fight them.
She don't know us.
I don't know, man. She probably could have been an awesome adventure before she got her ass kicked by these guys and turned into fucking...
Well, she has more experience with these particular kind of
We don't know
dwarves.
Her backstory.
It's true. You don't. Stop metagaming, Scruffles.
Yeah, man.
Not metagaming. All right, I'll be right back. We've got Torm on our side. Goddamn. Are we on the AFK screen, by the way?
No.
Oh. Why not? I won't take a
break. Because people are going to watch you eat.
Okay. I'm going to put up the AFK screen because Scruffles hey. Demands it.
Thanks. Everybody can thank Scruffles. So
thanks, Scruffles.
Yep.
Oh, an AFK. God.
Thanks, Scruffles.
All right. I'll be right back.
AFK screen's better, just saying.
Yeah. AFK, me dragging you by the leg away from your computer.
I never named names in that, just saying.
It you has keep red assuming. Hair.
You just keep assuming it's you.
It has short red hair. Don't even try to tell me otherwise.
Yeah, I never said it was me getting dragged away. It's just my stick figure.
Who the hell else would it be? Oh my god. I have a funny picture to show you guys. I'll put it in Skype. I don't know why I find that so funny.
Okay, I am back, but we're waiting for Scruffles. Thank you, Emptiness, again, for putting out all them links for us and everything. I appreciate it, man. Takes a load off.
Thank you, Emptiness.
I had to go feed my cat. I was getting yelled at. By the cat.
The kitty all like...
No, she doesn't sound like that. She just sits outside my door and meows until I come feed her. But that's good, because you know, like, if she's hungry, I feed her. And if she's hungry, she lets me know, and then I feed her. She's like, hey, hey, hey. That's kind of what she sounds like. She'll just sit outside my door and be like, meh, meh, meh.
You don't let your cat in your room?
Not when I'm streaming, no. Because then she's jumping all over shit.
But everybody loves watching that.
And she put the key on.
I love watching that, dog.
Well, not only that, but, like, I don't want my microphone picking up, like, my roommate's computer stuff. You know what I mean? Because, like, he plays games and shit, like, and it'll just be too noisy.
Yeah, I feel you. You should totally just lock
it. And I can't shut her in my room because then she'll get
confused. She'll be wanting to go out every 2 seconds and then come back in and then go back out.
I don't have a litter box in my room either, so that could provide a problem.
Mm. You should bring it in and just, like, put
the urine.
No, you're all brought to you by Chex Mix.
Perfect timing, Trip.
But not really.
Right as I change scene. Alright, so what'd you guys come up with?
I don't know, I was peeing.
Lou's scouting ahead while we wait for him to return, and if he takes too long, I'll go ahead. And they wait.
Are you peeking around that corner, Lou?
Yeah.
Okay.
Ina demands the kitty.
Damn this fucking long-ass tunnel stuff.
Alright. Well, she's eating right now. I'm not gonna bother her, but I'll bring her by and show everybody my cat.
Yay!
Relax. She's not that impressive.
She's like Deb. She's like, meow. Alright, so I pop around here and, oops, pop this corner here. Peeking. Peek in this corner. There's a mine shaft.
Leading Dawid.
Fuck, so now I gotta get these guys to move all the way over here. This would be cool if I had like a messenger rat I could let go with a little fucking note. Like, yo, everybody come, I fucking swear to God. If someone is too loud and we have to fight this fucking crazy ass dude and I didn't get a surprise shot on him, this is gonna be ridiculous because this dude can see if he's paying attention.
Can't tell if that's your color ammo or thoughts.
What?
The purple, because you both have purple.
Purple?
Mine's like a...
Wait a minute, question.
Red, purple.
I'm gonna refresh real quick.
Dog, what did this wall right here look like? It was made out of just dirt.
Well, it's just stone. It's been like mined.
Oh, it's like
rock
and
yeah,
shit.
Like
I can't just like
rock.
Chink, chink, chink. Made a new hole. No one's gonna know about it. Come this way.
Give the follow, Soul Sight. Appreciate that. Oh yeah, when my cat farts, it's fucking raunchy. Cause she only eats seafood. She's very picky about that. Like, she won't eat, like, chicken or turkey or anything like that. Like, anything she eats has to be fish or shrimp or something like that.
Damn,
like, I literally can't. Will not eat, like, any other kind of food.
Eh, my Nana's
she likes what she likes.
Has pretty rank parts. It's a wiener dog. And she thinks people
food. A dash hound?
Its breath is horrible. And she feeds it people foods. Like, she'll cook a steak and, like, make an extra little small baby steak for the dog. She spoils it.
And, like, while you're doing this, like, you know these dwarves, like, you have to move silently, but they're not standing there silent. They're all kind of, like, talking among themselves.
And
you know what I mean? Like, they're
So this guy represents more than one dwarf?
From there, I can give you, well, yeah, I can.
Or does
I
it just
well
sound
just
like there's
the
more
rest.
Behind this guy? And
well, you know
oh,
from the voices
God.
That there's more.
Fuck. All right. Yeah. So, like, do I need to make another move silently check to go back to the group? Do I need to keep doing these?
You'll need one more to get back to the group. Yes. You're good.
So I come back to these guys and I'm all like, "Yo, here's the drill. I'm gonna go point right. Fucking. Jack, you're gonna follow me. Astrid, you're gonna be next, and then Yuffie, you're gonna bring up the rear. Just give
Wait,
us a
I
little
asked,
bit." Wait,
I asked, like, what's going on? Like, what is up there?
There's a lot of fucking dwarves, right? There's a lot of dwarves, right? And I was coming around this corner, and there's a chick, right? So I was gonna rescue her and shit. And then I saw all the dwarves, and these dwarves, there's like a lot of them and shit. And she's toast cool. Like, just chilling there for now. We'll come back and get her at a later date.
But we can't just leave her here.
Yeah, hold on. She fucking told me to go, right? She wants us to go take this passage down, right? And I'm thinking maybe there's a lever to, like, dump lava on these guys or something somehow, right?
I can't just leave her here.
Well, we can't leave her here.
Torm would not want me to leave an innocent to suffer.
Okay, well, you already visited Torm once, like, pretty recently. I'm pretty sure he doesn't like you visiting twice in, like, the same year or some shit.
Torm loves me. We had tea.
I'm pretty sure he just tolerated you a little bit.
We had tea.
I mean, I'm sure it's pleasant, but, you know, there's those people that you go over their house, and you only go over there very randomly and with very long extended periods of time between it because they just like their personal space. That's your god, I think. Pretty sure, so you should just...
Well, that's nice, dear, but I think I know Torm.
Okay, well, you're gonna be on your own then. Have fun fighting all those doors by yourself, because I don't feel like dying. I've already visited my new magical god.
That we ignore her.
It was kind of a sticky experience. I'd just really rather not. I'll just look for porpoises and shit when I get a craving for my divinity's attention.
What?
This deity likes dolphins.
Yeah, dude.
Oh, okay. I didn't know that you had decided on a deity yet.
I met him when I died. We came to terms. He's like, "Yo, I'm your god. I'm taking care of you." And I'm like, "Oh, cool," because that's what I was looking for a while, because I didn't know who my god was. Because deep personal backstory shit I went over that you never pay attention to anyways.
Shit.
Anyway.
When shots get fired.
I'm kidding. Don't get mad.
She's furious. Look at her. She's doing She's that. I'm not mad. Fake smile.
I'm not mad, but I'm mad face.
Seething with hatred on the inside.
I can't wait till we're offline and I'm just going to tear you a new one.
You mean the face I make when you say certain things?
What, like chips?
Thank you for the follow, lethal consent.
So, I have the order of movement for March. Struffles.
That's not smart, though, because if I go last, I'm going to be alone.
You're not
going to
be alone. You're just last in the order. That way, we can...
No, I should go first so that if they, like, notice me because I'm going to be loud as fuck, they'll attack me first because I'll be, like, in this area.
You can't be loud as fuck. If they notice us at all, we're all dead. Like, it's one of those things. We're, like... We're level 2, they look like they're level 20. They've been working out, they're pretty roidy. They got some big fucking muscles.
Guns.
This shit, we cannot fight these. So if Guns. You feel like you need to strip down and leave your armor here or put it in your bag.
No.
Okay, what about your magic bag?
I thought you were gonna say something else.
We can just put it in your magic bag, right?
I'm not taking my armor off.
Okay, fuck. Well, you're going last then so the rest of us don't die and we'll fucking res you somehow if you... We'll take your body.
No, you won't.
To the temple.
Wow, you guys are the worst. You know what? I say fine. If I'm to fate, if I am to meet Torm again,
look, it's not going to be that so bad. You're not going to die. I will come and drag you through this tunnel. And
the rest of my party wish to leave me to die. And
we're
leave
not
an innocent
you, we're
woman
saying,
to suffer.
Oh my God. Look, lady. Look.
Listen, lady.
God damn it. The whole purpose is
no, I say it's fine. It's fine, dear. It's fine. I will go last.
My guy, like, fucking audibly, not, like, super loud, but, like, there's a quiet thump of facepalm that the party can hear. It doesn't travel farther than the party. Anyways, I lead the way to victory and life.
Karn. Oh, that's awesome.
What?
24-inch pythons, brother. Hulkamania is running wild.
So, how many silent... Can I just, like, roll all the silent checks in a row and get them out of the way? Like...
No, because of positioning. That's okay. The only reason why.
Fuck. I have to redo this whole shit again. So, I'm gonna move here.
Okay.
To here. To here. To here. No, straight here.
Okay.
Sure.
Just
so
do two move silently. Just do two, then.
25, 24.
You're good.
Okay. I'm basically, like, hidden in a niche here, waiting for everyone to, like, come around with me with
gotcha.
Their silent checks, and then I'm going to lead them. So I need to make 1, 2, 3, 4 slots open, maybe 5. So I need to be back here. I'm waiting for everyone. When I hear danger, I'm going to fucking, like, just grab people and fucking, like, drag them with me as we run away. Cause
okay, I have a quick meta question.
Sure.
Is taking your armor off a smart thing to do right now?
Could be.
I ain't taking my armor off.
This is the way I look at it. This is the way I
look at it. Well, I'm not smart, so fuck yourself.
If you fuckers aggro this shit, like, we're just running. We're not fighting these things.
Yeah,
it's like a toddler trying to pick a fight with his stepdad. It's just not gonna work.
Astrid, go next, because you're the squishiest.
Thought I had a sneeze coming, but it went away. Anyway.
Phantom sneeze heard.
Like, how far, like, can I go before I have to start making the silent checks?
Basically, like, once you hit, like, right here. Hold on. Yeah. Like, anything
okay.
past
so,
this
like,
point.
When I go to that, if I go to that square, the one right in front of Scruffles, that's when I'd start making
yes.
the silent check?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Okay, starting here.
I did my armor bonuses.
Nope, turn. There we go. So I'm going to move
Don't
here
turn.
First. And then do
turn
the same thing
what?
You did. So, moving here. And I'm going to do the same thing that Lou did where
just
I go.
Follow my footsteps.
So give me 2 move silently checks.
Alright. Come on! I get +2 for dex. I think. Yes.
Depending on the situation and the skill involved, lethal. 12 is good.
Alright. Where does that get me?
To, like, right here. Well, like, right here.
Okay. Now I'm gonna make the second one.
Mm-hmm.
Yay!
You good.
Okay.
So tense.
What is the max dex?
I'm just waiting to have to run when fucking Scruffles comes clanking.
I can't believe you're just gonna fucking leave a member of your party who's been
max
looking out for you this whole
We're not leaving
time.
You. We're encouraging you to follow us very quickly.
Mm-hmm. Scruffles, you had a max dex question?
Yeah, for the armor, it says max dex +1. I don't know what that means.
If I'm
max
not mistaken, that means, like, say
right.
your dex was 8 or something, and it says max dex 5, you can only benefit from up to 5 of that dexterity. Is that
right.
how that works? So,
exactly. Like, your dexterity score...
Far, wearing that armor is gonna only let you use so much of that dexterity.
Right. I have 0 for
okay.
dex then, so it's fine.
So instead of, like, 10 plus 8 dex plus 3 AC or whatever, you'd be 10 plus 5.
But The situation is, if you took the armor off, you're not getting the armor check penalty. So you're not getting bonuses to move silently, but you're not getting minuses either.
I'm aware of what would happen.
Okay. Yes. She's just itching for a fight. She just wants to get y'all killed.
Dude, I've already expressed.
I still have a DI.
This is impossible. When an NPC tells you can't fight something, you can't fight it.
She's just a slave lady. What does she know?
Half drow. If I get naked, can I just like blend in with the wall since it's kind of dim and get bonus? Since my skin's like black, like
don't
black,
be
black,
racist,
black. Trick. I'm not being racist. I'm talking about like.
Your skin might be dark, but you're still wearing armor and stuff, so.
No, I said if I got naked.
It's not that they don't see you, it's that they hear
you. Yeah, it's a matter of hearing, because they're not. None of them are looking that direction.
The move silent is basically, will they hear you moving or not? Because even if you tiptoe,
I'm not being racist.
You still might hear the metal.
I love how like, that's the thing he's the biggest concern about. I'm not being racist.
If you get naked, not they being won't racist. Hear you as much. But you could trip and fall. And
I mean, if you were like Scruffles, like with her armor set that was really loud and had a bunch of negatives, I could see getting naked because of that.
Yeah, I have a negative, so I want to.
I just don't want to take my armor because if I roll shitty and roll like a 2 or a 3,
you're gonna be running anyways.
You're gonna be fucked.
You're gonna be running anyways, regardless. Like you, a fight. You.
Why do you not want to fight? Why are you such a big old wuss?
Okay.
Because this is my turn to go. You don't have to fight everything.
Well, roll
right?
then.
And sometimes there's things put in there. For
somebody do something.
I'm just telling Thog that I'm taking my shirt off so I don't have the negative to Dex.
Oh, right.
All right, stud
like,
muffin.
Why the fuck would you take your armor?
Let's move it along then.
Here's the y'all. Jingly, jingly.
See, that is the rolls that I'm afraid of.
So that's your first move silently?
Yes.
Okay. They stop talking. And they're kind of like looking around.
Well, now they're alerted. I'm not going.
Can I wait until I hear them?
Yeah, like maybe 10-20 seconds goes by and then they start talking again.
Okay.
There's only one way I can see around this, really.
Let me see something.
I can distract them. Run out there screaming
you
and moaning, right?
And
I will leap off the side of the cliff. But I can't die because I got glide wings, son. And so I'll come in.
For her
while you guys get into your tunnel.
That makes no sense. They'll see me unless I can like hide somewhere.
Okay.
Which I can't because I'm terrible. I am not a hidey person.
You might have to take off your armor. You're not getting naked. You're just taking off your armor that's loud as fuck.
I don't think it matters because Trip just rolled an 8 and a 5.
But he can wait till the top. They can't see him yet.
Hold on.
So he's good.
Hold on. I need a listen check. From Scruffles and from Trip.
Fuck. Took so long as a patrol.
And then I'll explain what's happening. Okay, 20
oh
is.
Oh my god.
20 is
lethal.
Perfect. Alright, so what happens is Trip starts moving and he makes some noise and they start, like, looking suspicious. And right when they start doing that, the female slave just starts screaming at them, like, making a fucking ton of noise. She's banging shit around. And in the middle of that, you hear her say, go!
Okay, we go. We go!
Alright, so she's got them distracted. They're beating the fucking shit out of her.
Oh, no! Poor baby! I will come back and I will...
You hear screaming and beating on the other side of the stone wall.
Oh no, I don't want
to
leave.
I turn to her and I tell, I'm like, hey, I think I saw a necklace of Torm around her neck. Or whatever her god is.
Do you actually say that to me? Because my character would go back.
That's bluff versus sense motive. And you might be killing the party, Trip.
Aw, I won't.
No. He won't be killing the whole party. I will get the fuck out of there. I got glad wings, yo, and I'm on
top of
the
mountain.
No, I was
just gonna see her run back like.
But basically, I made two silent rolls. All right, the first one to see was if the female slave heard Trip make the noise, which she did, and then I made an intelligence check for her to assume, okay, there's more people in the party. I need to give them a distraction. So that's
She's
what you
human,
did,
right?
Yes.
Okay, so I'm not fazed by this at all, then.
I am.
That's cool.
I'm just saying,
like, I can carry on my wayward son. That it's something other that lyrics and whatever.
Talon trip to roll helicopter dick.
But yeah, I mean, even if they kill her, she's still making a noble sacrifice.
Yeah, but it's still, she's a human. I'm not really partial. It's not like I hate her, but I just, like, really don't care.
In front of you, there's, a small, like, crack in the chamber that you're in, Lou.
Like,
give me a spot
watch or die. Is that what you're saying?
Spot or die.
You're going to make me watch her die, and then, like, does this affect you? Does this 10 plus
Can I
think
put my
No, it's, like,
on?
Going towards the south.
Oh, yeah, plus 5. Spot 22.
Okay. Let me make some rolls. Wrong thing.
If only I had Intimidate and I fucking put a lot of ranks in it. Because I was going to be like, before we go down, I try to make the creepiest, most intimidating, scariest sound, like imitate a dragon.
Like a
gorilla. Left Intimidate to scare the guys away and maybe she can be free, but you know, whatever.
They would just fall.
I think that would be a bluff in it. To try to imitate a.
So it's going to be.
I can't do either, so.
I'm so sad.
I can bluff with plus 4.
Helicopter dick and hope for the best.
Oh, Lou, you spot it.
Yay.
So you are not a surprise when it attacks.
What?
Oh, shit.
What?
God damn it. I don't think I can be caught flat-footed anyways. No, I can't. Because I have the, what's it called? Did I put it in here or did I leave it? Uncanny dodge. There we go.
Ew.
What the fuck?
What the fuck is this thing? What is this fucking... What's that movie? Tremors?
Very similar.
But small, right? Smaller?
Yes.
Okay, so it's not Dune size. We're not on epic proportions here.
Yeah, it looks...
It's just shirtless.
It looks like a large worm, but with, like, 4 tentacles near its head and a beak. That's sign language for beak. In case y'all wanted to know that.
It's a beak.
Is beak. Alright. So it's going to attack Lou, who is not surprised.
Suck it.
It's gonna go for, let's see, what's its primary? Primary is tentacles, so it's gonna make one tentacle attack.
Ew, I don't wanna be in some hentai stuff. Come on, man.
Rollo.
Fuck you! This is bullshit!
You jinx yourself! Every time you say roll low, I roll a critical.
Fucking hate you. I hope you get a fucking one and another one. So you fucking just suck it. What the fuck is wrong with your roll system? It's broke all the time, you motherfuckers.
It does
time.
Seem to do that
this
a lot.
Is like the fucking.
Third it does
time.
Seem to do that a lot. Well, that's why, like, I don't know, RNG is weird. Like, you can't...
RNG is broke as fuck.
Yeah, that's gotta be broken. That's gotta be broken.
What are you doing?
Roll it again.
Try rolling it again.
Okay.
Not
like,
broken.
What? That's like,
but yeah,
what?
That's,
one in
that's crazy.
Or something?
I'm gonna take a firm stand on this and say that those 220s didn't happen, basically. Like, I'll say I confirmed the critical, and that's it. But it...
That's for, it's
the,
not so
the
much
first,
that happened.
The first
once.
Time it
this
happened,
is the
yeah.
Or third time, 320s in a row.
The first time it happened,
happened
I could have chalked that up to, like, random chance.
Right, yeah,
one in a billion, whatever the fuck it is. But it's been happening way too often. I really think that there's some kind of bug happening there, because that doesn't seem right to me. There's no fucking way that I'm that lucky. Or that you're that unlucky.
You shouldn't be fucking DMing D&D. You should be go fucking playing the lotto.
Yeah. No, Trip should be playing the fucking lotto. That fucking kid wins everything.
Who?
Alright, so we're gonna do one roll on the critical table. Fody 9.
This is ridiculous.
Alright, so standard critical, because that doesn't apply. And where the hell is it? There he is. You don't have, like, damage reduction or anything like that, right? Like, I can roll the damage all together?
Yeah.
It's not bad. Yeah, 7 damage.
Yay. It's better than fucking insta-death.
Well, I mean, when an ogre crits you, it's like, holy shit, this is gonna fucking hurt. But, like, this thing's not that big, you know what I mean? It slaps you with
a
tentacle.
That's why, like, the 320s in a row coming from this guy are just like, this is just, everything is amounting to, like, a fly taking out Mount Everest and, like, a nuclear strike attack. Like, what?
Yeah, that's, like I said, like, the first time it happened and the second time it happened, it was like, all right, okay. But this is literally, like, the third or fourth time where I've gone to confirm criticals and it's been 20-20-20. Like, that just shouldn't happen.
It's a 1 in 8,000 chance to happen.
Yeah. To have that happen 3 times in the course of, what, 2 months?
Yeah.
Like, those odds are just...
It's only good when the party's doing it a lot.
In the course the of,
like, I wouldn't give a shit if the party was doing it, but, like, I don't want to eat your fucking characters any more than you want them eaten, because then I gotta help you make new ones, you know what I mean? So, I'm gonna look into that, because at this point, that's just fucking crazy. Like, I'm gonna talk to some other people that use Roll20 and be like, does that happen with you guys, or... Like, I don't know, maybe that's it. Maybe I'm rolling too fast. Like, it hasn't had time to resolve, so it keeps giving the same result.
That sounds plausible, I guess is the right word. So I take it we're doing initiative now, right?
Yes. Let me just pull up the turn order.
My God.
Go ahead.
It can't have been more than, like, 8 sessions since our last time that happened.
No, not even. It's probably been, like, 4.
Chance for it to happen again.
You killed my warrior with, well, my barbarian with one.
Yep.
I think that's where I got the giant scar from.
Wasn't there another one that killed Lou or something?
Almost.
I think it was 220s in a row.
It was 220s in a row, and then the next time was another 220s in a row, and it fucking killed me. Like,
yeah, this is the second time it was 320s in a row.
Jesus Christ.
Roll your initiative, Jack.
Yeah, Jake.
It didn't go through.
What'd you get? 20?
20.
Okay. I'll keep that in mind. It even looks like a face hugger. Alright, so Jack is first.
I asked earlier if I could have put my armor on, but I don't know if you...
You don't have it on right now.
Okay. If I put it on, do I get attacked?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you're right next to it.
Can I whip him?
You may whip. Whip it good.
I wish we should have been a party full of Hadouzen, because then we could just, like, fuck psych, skip this, and just, like, open our wings and drop down the chute and be like, bye.
It's not that wide. You just nosedive.
Damn, never mind.
Because, like, you don't even have enough room to, like, spread out, you know what I mean? To, like, catch the air to, like, kind of drift down slowly, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You just, like, tumble down. Just, like, bouncing off the walls.
Some metal claws you could, like, skid down on the sides like this, maybe?
Does a 12 hit? A 12 does not hit.
Okay.
But good attempt. Hey, boo-boo!
Alright.
It's trying to eat you.
Can't really do anything. I'm stuck here, looking at its ugly, nasty face, where it almost tried to one-hit me when I saw it coming at me.
When it tried to eat your face.
Yeah.
I totally imagined,
if you do this to me,
like,
I will eat your face!
It, like, face-huggers his face and, like, just goes down his throat and out his chest.
Do I have to be at least 5 foot away to shoot him with a bow, right?
No, you should be able to
shoot. I can point blank
him
and just like, all right. I don't know if there was that rule or not. I keep putting 5 and it's 6, right? Plus 6. Composite, yeah, plus 6. I'm not even in the window anymore. 15 hit? I don't think so.
Natural armor takes a damage.
Fuck. So we need 16 or higher.
Astrid?
I hear sirens.
Yeah, ambulances are going mad crazy outside. All that monkey butt.
Really? I thought that was here.
No.
That's crazy.
Well, unless you got one too.
Maybe. Dude, there's always like ambulances and emergency vehicles around here because of where I live.
Can I hit him from here? I think I have clear line of sight right there.
Yeah, you got line of sight. Has LOS.
Those are some loud sirens.
Never mind, that's a shit ton of cops. It's like a raid, yo.
Oh, damn. They ain't taking Lou back.
Next thing we know, Lou's front door breaks down.
No, they're going away from me. That's three cop cars and an unmarked cop car, and they're hauling balls.
Like, if he got swatted right now, that wouldn't be funny.
Swatting is never funny. It's just not. Ever.
It's just stupid.
Let's see.
It's like the antithesis of funny.
4 damage. Oh, 5 damage. Yay!
5 damage. Max damage! Damn, Strunk with the fucking magic missile.
Nice.
It's called magic missiles, but since you're low level, you're only producing one right now. That's the reason why, like, when the damage scales, like, for each additional missile that you get, it's another 1d4 plus 1. So the damage will go to, like, 2d4 plus 2, then 3d4 plus 3, 4d4 plus 4. Or, actually, it might only go to 3d4. I forget. I'd have to look at the spell. It's been a while. Good hit. 5 damage.
That's right.
Yubajimimina.
I don't hit it.
You do not hit it. Trip.
Yes?
You look juicy.
No armor.
Lou, take a free.
Attack? Fuck yeah.
Yep, because it's going to climb up on the walls and then attack him from, like, above.
It can do that?
Yep.
I don't like this thing at all. 24.
That's a hit.
And 1d8. I wish I had fucking some strength, yo.
3 damage, and ammo did 5, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Alright, full attack on Trip. It's gonna be 5 attacks, buddy.
Wait. Can it... No. It can do a full attack after moving? You can do that? Or is it just this creature that can do it? Like, can you do that in general, or...?
I'm trying to figure that out, because it's not like the... But then again...
Because isn't it kind of like dual-wielding in a way?
If it was on the ground, then yes, because then it would just be five-footing and attacking, and you can full attack on a five-foot. But because it climbed, that's a good point, because then it's not 5 feet. Because then it has to go around the outside, so that would
so
be
you
more
could,
like 10
if you don't
feet.
5 foot adjust and you just move in, you can do a full round action?
No, you can do a full attack on a 5 foot adjust. But you can't move and full attack. You guys haven't gotten high enough levels yet where you get more than one attack per round.
So that's why I'm asking, because he just moved up, he moved, and then is doing a full round, right?
He's not. And that's good that you brought that up.
Okay. I'm just trying to understand for, like, if I ever was.
If he had... Well, honestly, like, he could just stay there. Oh, sorry. Didn't mean to...
Swap you guys out.
Yeah. Let me fix that. Okay. So if he had just stayed there, he could full attack on either one of you three, but he went and climbed above Trip. Like, mm-hmm. So he's on the ceiling above Trip, so he moved more than 5 feet. Because he would have had to climb up the back wall and then across the ceiling, which is why I gave you the free.
And if I would have had him,
so that was my fuck up.
Would I have gotten a second like attack of opportunity? Because
well, you can only get in a, unless you have combat reflexes, you'll only get one attack of opportunity. Per
right,
round.
But what I'm asking is, like in this case, this scenario, since we're in like a 3D space now,
mm-hmm.
because you're like thinking you got one grid going up, another grid going over, or whatever.
Right.
So technically, he'd be moving in two threatened squares that I, whatever in.
Right. So if you what, had combat reflexes,
right,
you could take
I would have
two.
Gotten a second one.
Yeah.
Okay, that's that all the, like, I know I can't do it now, but I was wondering if I'd had that feat, could I?
Yeah, combat reflexes is awesome, especially okay. when you're a monk, because then you're just like, Trip, I'm going to put you over here. Trip, I'm going to put you over here. Trip, I'm going to put you over here. Oh, you missed me? I'm going to trip you too.
Jeez.
Yeah, monks are a lot of fun if you play them right. They can be very, very dirty. I forget what edition we were playing. I want to say this is like right when 3.5 came out, and we made like high level characters because a buddy of mine wanted to try out DMing it, and I don't know why he allowed my buddy Jim to do this, but my buddy Jim was playing a monk, and the monk climbed up on the back of a dragon and then punched the, like, used his monk's stunning fist ability on the dragon and stunned it and brought it down. And then everybody else got attacks of opportunity and they just killed it.
Did he have to do, like, what was the checks? I'm thinking, like, climb, handle animal, ride?
Well, like, stunning fist, you get, like, a save against the stun effect. And he just rolled a natural one on the save, so.
Oh, God. That's what really fucked him over then.
Yeah. But even still, it was pretty epic. Watching a monk climb on the back of a dragon and fucking punch it in the back of the head. Fucking just drop it.
That's some intense epic level shit right there.
Yeah, but like we were... I think the characters that we had made were like 15th level, something like that. So they were fucking up there. Like even the save DC for the monk's stunning fist was pretty high. But fortitude save for a dragon is like... Yeah, whatever. Because they're fucking massive. Unless you have, like, a young dragon. Alright, so we got off topic.
Mm-hmm.
Attacking Trip. One tentacle. Fifteen?
Yes, because I don't have my... Well, it would have hit if I had my armor on. But my AC with my armor is 15.
Six damage, max damage. No, Trip, don't fall down the hole.
No, I was just moving it so I could.
I know. I gotcha. Alright, that was everybody, so let me clear the list and we will do initiatives.
Oh, so, like, okay, that's why I got confused, Thug. I thought you were, like, he had, like, more than one tentacle, and he was attacking with all five tentacles or something.
They do have more than one tentacle. They have four tentacles.
Right, when you said the full round thing or whatever, how you worded it, that's what I was thinking. It's like, this thing moved up there, and now it's going to get five attacks on him. And that's why I was like, damn, that's going to suck.
There are certain creatures that can do that, though.
Right, and that's why at first I was like, that seems pretty OP. Like... Fucking 20. Could use that 20 for something else.
Okay. Yupigenomina?
Oh.
Yupigenonymous?
Right. Okay, he's right there. That's fine.
You would have had to move to hit him anyway.
No, he's right there, though.
He's over here, on the ceiling.
Oh!
So you would have to move here. so please do that.
Oh, I didn't...
It's okay.
But the thing is there!
No, he's here. He's on the ceiling above Trip.
Why don't you put him on Trip's block, then?
He is.
Right now I see me standing on him, so I'm confused.
You're standing on a pile of rubble.
Yeah, no, he's there. I swear to God, he's right there.
See him?
Nope. Probably I'm still standing on him.
Probably lagging. Alright, well, that's roll 20 is bad, I guess. Alright, Boo Boo.
Did you attack? Oh, okay. Shit. Like, this is the worst way for me to fight right now. I'm just gonna 5 foot adjust.
Lou, how many ranks in dungeoneering do you have?
2.
Okay.
You want me to roll?
Just metagame stuff, if you put 5 ranks in knowledge dungeoneering, it'll give you, like, attack bonuses on certain types of creatures.
Where does this information come from? I need to know things like this.
I'm pretty sure it's in the player's handbook.
Under what?
Probably knowledge. If it's not under knowledge, then there's a separate table for, like, synergy bonuses.
I need to be all about those.
But I know if you have 5 ranks in, like, certain knowledges, you get a bonus on attacking certain types of creatures, and then on top of that, you also get, like, another kind of synergy bonus. Like, for Dungeoneering, I think it's, hold on. Gonna cough.
You made me waste a good roll that could have got through that dude and hit him on a Dungeoneering check. It better be worth it.
I'll give you a +1 to hit.
Yay.
Even though you don't have the ranks, but...
The ranks? Oh.
You have to, like, have 5 or more to get the bonus.
3 more ranks. That's what I'll do
next. Yeah, I remember we did this with your other guy's characters. We did all our synergy bonuses. It's like having 5 ranks in whatever skill might give you a bonus on other skills situationally or...
Was I there for that?
Oh yeah, definitely.
I don't remember that at all.
I remember
it.
We definitely did that. I'm positive.
I mustn't have gotten any synergies.
Probably not.
Does anyone else?
Because you don't have a lot of skills.
Yeah.
Wait, when was this just this
random? I think Scruffles did. I think you're rogue.
Synergies. Did what?
No, synergies on the last character.
Yeah. She doesn't
Scruffles
remember.
Is like gone. She doesn't know what we're talking about.
She doesn't even pay attention. Doesn't even care.
Mm-mm. He's like, it's not my turn. So I rolled an 18.
Okay. So I'll give you a +1 on the attack.
But what was I rolling for?
Knowledge dungeoneering.
Yeah, but for what? Just for that +1?
Right, to know like what kind of creature it is. Like if the bonus to the attack is based off the knowledge of like you would know where to hit this thing kind of thing.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Like that's
okay.
How
I just
it
didn't
works.
Know if you were gonna like spit some knowledge at me that I needed to shut up so you could say.
Well, after combat I'll explain why it applies.
Okay. So plus an extra 1, that would make it a D6 plus so 7. Fuck me.
Still a miss, but it's an aberration. That's why you're getting the damage bonus for your knowledge dungeoneering.
An aberration?
Yep, it's a kind of creature.
I don't like these, because...
Aberration is like this thing, beholders, rust monsters, gibbering mouthers. Those are lots of fun. 7 bite attacks. They tend to have lots of attacks, because they tend to have lots of mouths or limbs.
They're just dickholes.
Basically, yeah.
And they're fighting me in an area that is, like, shitty for my class, because I need to move 10 squares to be able to do, like, you know, really good damage.
Lou's like, I'm fucking boxed in over here!
I'm trying to figure a way out around this.
Alright, so that was Boo Boo. Next is Astrid.
Okay.
you gonna do, lady?
I don't know if I'm gonna be getting anybody's way, but I'm gonna 5 foot here.
Mm-hmm.
And pew pew pew.